Let's look at two of the early modern conjugates together. The first one is AlexNet. As we've seen in the previous video, it kicked off the deep learning revolution in 2012, and it was developed by Alex Krizhevsky, Ilya Sutskever, and Jeff Hinton. AlexNet consists of 8 layers, 5 convolutional, and 3 fully connected layers, and it has a total of around 60 million parameters. It was trained on 2 graphics processing units, or GPUs, and because one GPU did not have enough RAM, they split up the network in 2 parallel paths, one on each GPU. And those 2 paths exchanged information only after some of the layers to reduce communication overhead. And in addition, AlexNet introduced 2 important innovations. The first was dropout, which they introduced in the fully connected layers to regularize the network. So dropout stochastically deactivates neurons during training. In each iteration, half of the neurons' activations are set to 0. And in each iteration, we pick a new random set, a new half of the neurons that are set to 0. As a result, the network cannot rely on specific units, but instead it has to learn a distributed code that is robust to deactivation of random sets of neurons. And then at inference time, when all the neurons are turned on, one can think of the network as acting like an ensemble of networks. The second important innovation of AlexNet was replacing the activation function. Until 2012, neural networks would usually use sigmoid activations, such as the hyperbolic tangent shown here in green. What those guys have figured out is that if you replace the activation function by a rectified linear unit, short ReLU, the networks they train much faster. And the ReLU activation is actually quite simple. You set all the negative activations to 0, and you leave all the positive activations passed through unchanged. So we've seen AlexNet before, and we've seen how it performed. So it really smoked the competition in 2012, and it beat everybody by around 10 percentage points. And AlexNet really constituted a milestone in deep learning. And the paper has now been cited more than 80,000 times. The second network I want to look at is VGG. It was developed by the Vision Geometry Group at Oxford, hence its name. The main innovation of VGG was simplifying the network architecture substantially. It contained only 3x3 filters and max pooling. So these are the only 2 operations used throughout this network. Training VGG took 3 weeks and 4 GPUs, and it was pretty complex. Train the deepest 19-layer version of the net, they started by training an 11-layer version, then inserted additional layers, trained again, inserted more layers, trained again, and so on until they arrived at the final full 19-layer version. And VGG is really a beast. It has around 140 million parameters, and its weights alone require about 500 megabytes of disk space. VGG has been really popular for quite a long time, although it actually didn't win the 2014 ImageNet competition. The reason for its popularity were primarily its simple and clean architecture, and the fact that the pre-trained network was readily available, and still it halved the error rate of AlexNet roughly. The downside of VGG was that it was slow and complex to train. It was also huge, which made it difficult to deploy it. And another downside of the simple 3x3 convolutions in the architecture is that the first couple of layers were actually quite expensive to compute. So for the exercise, we're going to look into some detail at AlexNet and what it has learned. We'll visualize some of its filters, and we'll investigate how the resulting feature maps look given a specific input image.